Now I understand there is an open investigation into what happened here.
Yeah, so NOAA's Division for Law Enforcement is actually investigating what happened. They won't talk about this investigation, but likely looking into whether Washington State Ferries could have done anything different. Could they have seen the whale any sooner? Last night that we saw, there was a Coast Guard search to try to find this whale. Remember, this happened just after 8:15 when this ferry took off toward Bainbridge. They were only about 3 minutes into their trip when passengers say the whale popped up about 5 to 10 feet away from the ferry. So you see Coast Guard out there searching for that whale. They never did find it. Likely it has sunk if it did die. You can see in these photos we're going to show you now, these were taken by Matt McDonald, that you could see right in front of that ferry, there's that whale. And because of these photos, we were able to tell that it is in fact a humpback whale, not a gray whale like they originally thought. So there are those photos with that humpback whale right in front of the ferry. It popped up so close to that ferry, as you can see, the crew wasn't able to see it before they struck it, but passengers did see what happened and what can only be described as a gruesome aftermath. Let's take a listen to Gregory Foss with Washington State Ferries.
The crew's extremely upset. The crew feels horrible about the incident. I mean, had they been able to prevent it, they obviously would have. These are folks that have, you know, worked on the water for decades. The captain and the mate have been Washington State employees for over 20 years. They feel devastated the fact that they happen to be the ones that were there that day when the whale decided to surface right in front of their ferry.
So as we heard earlier, Gregory Foss saying that this has never happened with Washington State Ferries. I checked with NOAA as well. They say there's no record, at least going back to 2000, of any ferry that's hit a whale, which is actually kind of surprising. But since 2000, they say that there have been 23 fatal ship strikes in our area. But this happening in Elliott Bay, yeah, in front of all of these people, able to really see what happened, it's really captured a lot of attention.
Yeah, it's an incredibly sad story, too. Simone, you know, we obviously cover a lot of the orcas. We know about gray whales. Hearing about a humpback whale in Puget Sound, is that unusual? Do they usually swim in these waters?
It is a little unusual to see a humpback whale in Elliott Bay. I don't know that a lot of people remember seeing that. We have been seeing a lot more gray whales, which is why I think people thought initially that this was probably a gray whale. But when I talked to a researcher of humpback whales, he said that we are seeing more humpback whales in the Puget Sound and in the Salish Sea. The population is recovering. And so because of that, they're not quite surprised that this whale is down here, but they never would have really guessed that this would have been one of the routes where this could have been more dangerous. They definitely expect these types of confrontations between whales and ships to happen more toward the San Juan Islands, where there's more traffic.
Do they swim sort of like we see the orcas swim in pods together in groupings, or less so?
They're a lot more isolated. Sometimes the humpbacks swim one or two, but the biggest risk factor here is that they dive for so long. They can be down under the water for about 15 minutes. So they really can just surface right in front of that boat, and it can be too late.